Hey guys, and welcome back to Final Cut Pro Thursdays. In today's video, I'm going to show you how to fix lens distortion, or the fisheye effect caused by wide-angle lenses, like the ones found in GoPro cameras. There's a few different ways to accomplish this, and I will show you the two methods I like to use. If you like this video, please hit the thumbs up button and subscribe to my channel. Ask any questions you may have in the comments, and I will do my best to help you out. The first method uses a wide-angle fix plugin from alex4d.com. If you haven't yet, go to alex4d.com, download and open the installer app, and follow the on-screen instructions. For more information on downloading and installing plugins, check out my previous video. I'll link it in the description and up top. Using this method, everything can be done right in Final Cut Pro application. I have some footage in my demo project shot with a GoPro camera using the wide capture setting. This is a great setting because it captures a very wide field of view in your video. One side effect, though, is anything towards the edges of your video gets distorted and curved, and this is referred to as the fisheye effect. This is very apparent if you have objects with straight lines, such as buildings or trees close to the edge of your video. I'll select my clip, open the effects browser, find the wide angle fix effect plugin, and drag and drop it over my clip. What this will do is zoom in on your video a little bit and straighten out the edges. I'll open the inspector and toggle this effect on and off. Pay attention to the tree on the right side and the walkway at the bottom. Much straighter, but we do lose quite a bit of footage at the edges. From the inspector, you can choose from one of the included lens presets or select custom and use this slider to adjust the amount of effect applied. You can select this grid checkbox to display grid lines over the viewer to help you with an adjustment slider. You can also straighten out the horizon by selecting Rotate and Scale Clip from the drop-down menu and using the Rotate handle in the viewer. This will rotate your clip and scale it up at the same time to fill a picture frame. The second method I use to fix fisheye effect is using the GoPro Studio app before I import the clips into Final Cut Pro. This app can be downloaded for free from GoPro's website. I'm not a big fan of using this app to edit video, but it does have a couple features missing from Final Cut Pro. So when I know I have one or more clips with fisheye effect that I need to fix, I fix them with GoPro Studio before importing into Final Cut Pro. I'll open GoPro Studio, click on the Import button, and select the clip I want to fix. I'll select the clip and click on the Advanced Settings button. Here, I always leave the image and frame rate the same as my source clip, set the quality to high, and select the Remove Fisheye checkbox. Now I can rename my clip, choose the file destination, and click Add to Conversion List. The video file is added to my conversion list. After all my files are added, I'll click this Convert button. Now, I'll close GoPro Studio and import the converted files into Final Cut Pro. I'll review and compare my clips. With the wide angle fix plugin, more fisheye is removed, but you also lose more footage from the clip edges. And with the GoPro Studio method, you keep more footage, but less effect is applied. The method I use depends on the clip and how I want my finished product to look. If you found this video helpful, hit the like button and share it over your social media. New Final Cut Pro tutorial videos release every Thursday, so hit the subscribe button and turn on notifications so you don't miss them. If you're on Facebook or Twitter, I would love to connect with you. Links to my accounts in the description. Thanks for watching, and until next time.